गुड मॉर्निंग क्लास. टुडे इन दिस लेक्चर वी आर गोइंग टू डिस्कस आवर सेकेंड प्रैक्टिकल ऑफ द डेटाबेस मैनेजमेंट, दैट इज यूज ऑफ रिलेशनल अलजेब्रिक ऑपरेशंस. ओके, डेटाबेस इज एन फोर्थ सेम सब्जेक्ट एंड द कोर्स कोड ऑफ द डेटाबेस दैट इज 22416. द टाइटल ऑफ द प्रैक्टिकल नंबर सेकेंड दैट इज यूज ऑफ रिलेशनल अलजेब्रा ऑपरेशन. Let us see one by one the content of our practical number second. First of all, practical significance. In a database, all the statements which are used for retrieve the data or information are known as a query. And this query can be written in a high-level language or by using a special type of structure known as a relational algebra. In relational algebra, one can make use of certain symbols known as a operators. And relational algebra takes a relation, that is a tables, as an arguments which executes specified operators on it and returns a result based on the condition. Based on that condition, it returns a result. And this practical allows students to use relational algebra and retrieve the data from a given table. These are the practical significance, means introduction of our practical. Next is this. That is relevant program outcomes, POs. POs for this practical, that is basic knowledge, then discipline knowledge, ethics and lifelong learning. These four are the practical outcomes of this practical. Next, that is competency and practical skill. This practical is expected to develop the following skills in you, means in a student, that is apply database management concept using SQL, means select the appropriate database product, get familiar with the environment and options of the database product, availability of the various options and commands with their uses, check output and verify various properties parameters of table and database. And CO related to that practical, that is address the course outcome, that is create database using SQL command. And the practical outcome for this practical, that is write queries using relational algebra, algebraic operations. Okay, and the relevant effective domain related to that outcome, that is follow ethical practices, demonstrate analytical and logical knowledge as an individual, participate in a team problem solving activities, and prioritize the time efficiency to meet the needs of team and the self. This is the minimum theoretical background which is provided in our manual. Read this theoretical background, means what is the data, what is means by algebraic operators. Okay, next point, that is procedure. Select the appropriate database, this is the first step. Then choose the required schema, means choose the particular or required schema. Write the relational algebra statements with the help of suitable operators. And last, verify and note down the result. Okay. This is the additional resources required, that is software. And this is specification. As per batch size, we use this software. Okay. Then precautions to follow this or to implement the second practical. First of all, follow these precautions, use of appropriate operators, then select the required relations and use the relevant condition. These are the additional resources used. If you want to add or if you use any additional resources, then write down here additional resources used. Then result of this practical number second, in this practical we perform the relational algebra operations. Okay, or we successfully implement the relational algebra operators on a database. Okay, and practical related questions. First question, practical related, that is what is tuple calculus, what is mean by tuple calculus, and what are the different operators available in a relational algebra, available relational algebra. This point we already discussed in a theory video lecture, what is mean by relational algebra and the different relational algebra available in a database. Okay, first of all we'll see what is tuple calculus. Tuple calculus means what? It is a non-procedural query language unlike a relational algebra. And tuple calculus provides only the description of the query, but it does not provide the methods to solve it. Thus, it explains what to do, but not how to do. This is called as a tuple calculus, which is a non-procedural language. It is a non-procedural query language. Let us see the different relational algebra operators available in a database. Relational algebra is a procedural query language. It is also a procedural query language, and which takes the input and produces output in the form of instance of a relations is called as a relational algebra, and uses operators to perform a queries. These operators or an operator can be either a unary operator or a binary operator, and relational algebra is performed recursively on a relation, and intermediate results are also considered relations. Okay. Following are the basic relational algebra. First is the selection relational algebra, second that is projection, third that is joining, fourth union, set difference, intersection, Cartesian product and the division operation. First, a selection operation. As the name suggests, a selection, it selects the rows that satisfy the given statement from a relation. This is a unary operator or unary operation. Notifications and examples of this selection operator we already discussed in our theory lecture. Okay. Next, that is projection operator. What is mean by projection? Projection, this is also a unary operator like a selection, and a subset of relation based on the condition specified is created by this operator. Means it considered only selected columns from the relation for the vertical subset of the relation, and it is denoted by the pi. Okay. Pi, then the name of the attribute, and in a bracket we write the relation. Okay. Next, that is joining operator or a joining. Join is used to combine the related tuples from the multiple relations, and there are a multiple join operators, that is outer join, inner join, okay, left join, right join, natural join, equijoin. These are the types of join. Next, that is union operator. What is mean by union operator? Union means this is the binary operator, and the binary union between the two given relations is performed. Okay. And in union operator, special symbol is used which indicates the set of membership, and means it is an element of. Means this is a set membership symbol is used. And for the union operation, some rules are followed. That is, same attributes or same number of attributes is required when we apply a union operator. Then domain of every column must be same. Domain means the column name of the first relation is present in the column name of a second relation. Okay. Then third, that is set difference. What is mean by set difference? Set difference is a same rule is followed for a set difference algebra, and the set difference means the difference operation generates a group of tuples which are present in the first relation but are not present in a second relation. Okay. And same rule is followed like a union operation, that is number of column must be same and domain of every column must be same. Okay. Next, that is intersection. Intersection operation means intersection is it is a binary operation, and it gives the result in a relation with the rows which are present in both the relation. Okay. Next, that is Cartesian product, or we can say that it is a cross product. It combines the information of two different relations into one. This all the points or this all the algebras we already discussed in our theory session, so that I am not explained here briefly. Means what is selection, what is the notation of selection operators, and what is the example of selection operator, etc. Okay. Next, that is division operation. What is mean by division operation? Division operation is a binary operation. Is a binary operation that is written, that is R division of S. Okay. This is the all different relational algebra operators. Thank you. In manual, in database manual, there are some exercise provided by MSB team. Some questions are there. First of all, consider the following schema. Write the relational algebra statements for the student. There are three tables or three relations. First of all, you have to create it. That is student with the attribute SID, name, address and subject. The second, that is course, having the attribute course code and the title, and enroll having the attribute SID and the course code. Okay, and depending on the relation, they provided three questions. First, that is list the titles of courses that have students enrolled on them. For this question, we have to write the answer by using the projection operator. Means projector only select the titles from the relation, that is course relation. Likewise, you have to solve the second question and third question. Write down these questions on your notebook. Okay, thank you.